that is the destruction of life. Those who engage in such panatipata activity, they are called panatipatin. One who takes the life of a living being, panatipatin. So, for lay people, it is a bad thing or demerit or unwholesome action. For monks, also it is a very, very grave offense, parajika offense, grave offense. But there is a somewhat extraordinary thing there, unusual thing there. Supposing a novice monk, samanera, novice monk, kills an animal, then he loses his samanera, novice monk. Then he has to again observe precept if she needs if he need to lead the samanera life. Supposing higher ordained monk, in case higher ordained monk, normally higher ordained monk definitely they don't do such things, but in case if a higher ordained monk kills an elephant, he is not breaking his parajika offense, but just breaking the panatipata precept, not breaking the parajika offense. You see, if a higher ordained monk kills a human being, then he comes to the parajika level. So that, what do you mean by that? That means parajika offenses are so serious, and parajika offenses are not the normal things. In this way, we have to understand the difference between novice monk and higher ordained monk. Normally, real higher ordained monks never kill an animal, because killing an animal means no spiritual development. This suggests that in case, supposing a poisonous one comes to the room, the higher ordained monk is just living alone, no way, he is helpless, hopeless. So what is the more valuable life? The serpent, supposing a serpent comes, what is the valuable life? Human life or serpent life? Human life. And there also the higher ordained life is more valuable. That serpent comes and definitely bite and kill the higher ordained monks. But anyway, certain higher ordained monk with higher development mental state never tries to kill that one. But in case that higher ordained monk kills that poisonous snake, no parajika offense. But he breaks a simple precepts. That papa, supposing that poisonous one come and definitely bite and kill the monk. If it is so, his papa is lower power. I mean the very little bit of power. To the layman also the same. In case he is in difficult situation, a poisonous one comes and definitely he bites and kills this person. So there we have to see the difference between human life, importance of human life, and the importance of poisonous. In this way, we have to understand the precepts. So, supposing we don't know, we unwillingly we do certain things and mosquitoes go. Very simple. It's very simple part. If mosquito bite, then we will be suffering from a very serious dengue fever or something like that. We will be dying. So at that time we have to think of the importance of I am not encouraging to kill such ones. I am saying that the doctrinal matters. I am explaining the doctrinal matter. It is my duty. So I am not encouraging. If we can abstain in such cases also, far better. I am not encouraging it. But that is the doctrinal matters and commentaries say. We have to contrast the importance of two lives, right? Then take for instance adinnadana, taking what is not given. In our society, human society, we find many robbers. We scare off robbers. They come and do certain harmful things. So that's why if we observe the adinnadana precepts, that means that we are giving